Okay, so hello guys. In this video, we are going to see what are bitwise shift operators and as well as the logical operators. So first of all, let us see what are bitwise operators, shift operators actually. So suppose I write a equals to 4 and I did left shift of a to 4. So what is left shift? We'll see it. Suppose I write b equals to a and I left shift it by 1. So we'll see how to left shift in notepad actually. So what is the binary value of 4? It is 0100. Okay, I increase the size. And afterwards, if I did left shift, what does it mean is, it simply means we just have to remove the leftest element. The element that is to the leftest side, we just have to remove it. So I'll just remove that element and pad a 0 to the right side. So I'll just pad a 0 to the right side. So this was the left shift. So basically what I did is, wait, I'll write 4 again. So this was the original number. 0100. What I did is, I just shifted this whole thing to the left side and I removed this 0. And I padded 10 to the right side. That's all I did. So this is left shift. So what this number became? It became 8. So when I print out B now, what I'll get is 8. See, from 4 it got converted to 8. Now if I'll do right shift, now you guys can do it actually. So hold on, I'll just open notepad. You can solve it for yourself as well. So see, again 4 is 0100. And if I did right shift, so I just have to shift these numbers to the right side and remove the right side, the element to the rightest side, we just have to remove it. So I'll just remove that element and I'll pad 10 to the leftmost side. So what the original number was, it was 0100. So now that number became, when I did right shift, it will become 2. This is the binary value. So when I print out B, what I'll get is 2. So that's it for bitwise shift operators. We can just perform left shifts and right shift to the binary values or to the bits. And after that comes the logical operators. So in logical operators, there are, I think, three types. Yes. So suppose I write a equals to 4 and say b equals to 10. There are three types of logical operators actually. So I'll just write them over here. They are AND, OR and NOT. So the three types are AND, OR and NOT. So logical operators, they give nothing but just the logic. So logic means true or false. So they can give the outputs as true or false. So I can write c equals to, I have to mention two conditions for AND, OR, and for NOT there is only one condition, only one operand actually. So AND, so for AND I need two conditions. So if I want to check two conditions, say one condition is A is greater than 5. If A is greater than 5, and I'll write them that in parentheses, and after that I'll write AND B is greater than say 6. So what is this value? So see, we just have to use the AND operation. So see, A is greater than 5, it is true. No, it is not true, it is false, because A is 4. B is greater than 6, it is true. So false and true, the output will be false. So when I print out C, what I'll get is false as the output. See, I got false. And suppose I write less than 5. So now these two conditions are true, so I'll obviously get true as the output. Now for OR condition, any one of them should be true. So in this case, both of them are true. So obviously the output will be true. But now if I did A is 4, so if I did A is greater than 5, then this value is false, but this value is true. So the output will still be true, because for OR, we just need one condition to be true. So that's why the output is true. But see, if both the conditions are false, then the output will be false. That's OR operator. Now NOT operator. So for NOT operator, remember, the value of 0, the logical value of 0 in Python is false. But for all the numbers except 0, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to anything, the value is true. So the logical value of say 5 is true, but the logical value of 0 is false. So first of all, let us try to print out the logical value actually. Instead of that, actually we'll just do it. So see, if I print out say C equals to NOT 4. So see, the logical value of 4 is true, but if I write NOT 4, that is the opposite of it. So the opposite of true will be false. So when I print out C now, I got false, because 4 is true, but NOT 4 is false. Now after that, if I write C is not 0, so see, the logical value of 0 is false, so the NOT of false will be true. So now if I print out C, it will be true. So these were the bitwise shift operators and the logical operators, that is AND, OR, or NOT. So that's all I need to tell you for this video. I'll meet you all in the next video. Thank you.